So PACT, obviously Child and Family Services DuPage, with the early intervention program from age 0 to 3, both John and Christopher were involved in that, and so was Jack as well when he was of that age and after his transplant returning from Duke University.
I remember that we had wonderful therapists. We have therapists who actually, even though the boys were 3 years old when they quit using the services, they still are in touch with us today. These are people who genuinely cared about my children. They wanted them to succeed. They wanted them to move forward. And just the care, the energy, the positivity that these people demonstrated was wonderful. Back in the day, we were new to all of this. We didn't know how to navigate special needs services and you know, how to navigate our children's disease and care. And these folks helped us to do that. And they were very encouraging and very positive and helped us through this journey that we were starting on. And so we were very thankful to them. We had wonderful therapists and they all were lovely people.
Funny story, speech therapist comes in for Christopher from one of the vendors that contracts with Child and Family Services. And she was a new speech therapist. And Christopher was a very tenacious child when he was younger. He reminds me a lot of my wife, very stubborn and strong-willed would be the way I would describe that. And anyways, she was a new grad, and we had a room set up where he would sit with the therapist and do his therapy. So one day he decided he didn't want to participate, so he would not respond to the therapist. And the therapist was just some young 20-something girl, so she comes out and tells me about this. So I go in and I kind of scold Christopher and tell him that he's gotta do this. And so she goes back in, starts it back up, and he takes his chair, because he's able to move about, and turns around and faces the wall, away from her, just looks at the wall. And so the therapist comes back out and tells me this. And so I go back in and I'm livid now. I'm telling the kid that if he doesn't do this, he's gonna go to bed. And where he was on the first floor of our home, and his bedroom was on the second floor. And he knew where it was in proximity where he was at. And defiantly, he just simply stared at the wall and he took his hand and he pointed to his bedroom. And that's where he went. And that was the end of it, and she never came back. So that was probably the most interesting experience we had with the early intervention program. But what I want to say about early intervention was that had the boys had cerebral palsy, we actually saw a benefit. They actually increased in their abilities, both from a physical therapy, a speech therapy, an occupational therapy standpoint. And as we know, the literature shows that early intervention does improve children that have disabilities that aren't degenerative. And I think had the boys truly had what they would have had, it would have helped them tremendously, because we felt very confident that they were improving. And then, of course, they took that downturn because just their nervous systems were being overwhelmed by the disease. But yeah, I mean, so my funny story about that was with the speech therapist. But in all seriousness, it is an important program, and it's very fortunate that we're able to have children from 0 to 3, you know, involved in that in their homes, because oftentimes it's tough to get those kids in therapy outside of the house. So yeah, that's kind of a mixed of answers, but that's kind of what I remember.